Okay, all right. I'm Jeff Mann. With me, as always, is Skyler. Are you guys ready for a fantastic day of professional wrestling? And of course, we're here with Justice and Drake.
Scobbles.
He has the purest heart in the universe.
As weird as that is. Alright. Chad Ugly is not what you call.
As far as I can tell, I'm looking at a bunch of people.
Oh, Chad Cobbles, I wasn't done talking!
That's too bad, because you got the moral barometer of a pack of wild coyotes that got enough brain cells to equally split a six pack. You don't have to worry about me. I'm here to fight. I want some revenge on each and everybody. Johnny Blake, I'm looking the most of you. Don't even worry about it. I'm gonna get redemption. My friend, you put him in the hospital, but do you even care? How long have you known Chad Hockley? Ladies and gentlemen, the master traveling universe is Chad Hockley. What happened to Team Science?
Chad!
Master traveler. He can't hear you because he's in the hospital right now.
Oh, no.
You know what, Cobbles? We have a minute! Uno momento!
It looks like the Super Lucha Friends going into a huddle.
Yeah, they need to think about it. They need to process some calculations because they don't know how to deal with the situation. All right, Dr. Cobbles. You want to fight the Super Lucha Friends? El Maldora and Castro and Outrageous? That's what you want to do? I'll fight all three of you. That's exactly what I want to do.
You got it!
Oh. Right, that was easier than I thought. All right, but this is great. This is great. None of you are.
Let's do this, Cobbles. Come on.
Hang on. In what universe do you think someone named Doctor is going to be foolish enough to step in here alone against the three of you? What universe, pray tell? All right. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I happen to have secured myself a little backup for just such a situation as you accepted the challenge, despite being a bunch of cowards. That's right, I got a little help, and he's maybe a little familiar to some of you. His name, Adin Reyez.
Hi.
Sorry. At the moment, we're now joined by El Rey.
Adin.
Is this it? Okay, let's start.
from what I'm looking at.
Yeah, because you look stupid.
I don't know how stupid I look compared to you. I'm looking at the Super Nacho Friends.
Yeah, you take that back, Adin Reyez. I will take that back.
Listen, and as ridiculous as I look, your mom didn't complain last night. Oh, I'm gonna let him have his mini stroke.
Get to your point, Miguel, and don't talk about my mama!
Okay, sorry. I've been up and down this continent, and I've never seen people as ridiculous as you guys. My bad. But, it isn't just, you know, 3-on-2. I'm not dumb enough, he's not dumb enough, the doctor here isn't dumb enough. So we did manage to find someone else.
Ooh. Oh, you know.
Wait. Your girlfriend?
Who else could it possibly be?
Search your feelings, Martha.
What is that? I don't know the music.
That music is new to me.
Are we fighting the bass monster? You know, fellas, it's not all this dramatic music that I tell you. What we're going to do to Dr.Cobbles and Adin Reyez.
I am the king of Lucha Libre, with our wretches and with the astral.
I know where you're going. Opponent.
Sorry, Jesus.
carries the HIW gold, and that is an honor not many grapplers have had. This should be a great match to get us started.
I have too much hardware over here, Jeff Van.
We're going to need a wheelbarrow to carry all those belts. Looks like both competitors are ready. And Skyler, ring the bell. Let's start the match. And here we go. Houston, Arizona. Adin Reyez, Cris Syndel.
Shut up.
He's been in the ring maybe not even a minute. And the fans are already behind him. Syndel taking his time for experience of the two. Adin Reyez got to have some butterflies. His first time at the big show. And here we go, power elbow tie up.
Come on, Syndel.
That was not a good sign that both have the tag team champions.
Get him out of the corner. Get him out of the corner.
Adin Reyez gives him a clean break. Nicely done.
Stop cheating. Wrestle like a real man.
Can you play someone's hair if they don't have
to?
That's a great question. And now back to the collar and elbow tie-up.
Come on.
For a second, Syndel was getting the better, but it looks like it's Adin Reyez all the way.
Come on, 1, 2, 3. Get him out of the corner.
Oh, no clean break given by Syndel. Punch the face, yeah, kick the gut.
You want to show me?
The ref on the ref catch will fight pretty quickly. Yeah, Syndel disrespecting the HIW rookie. What's up with that? Adin Reyez not going to take it.
Man,
get some right hooks. Yeah, big right hands. Syndel is in a world of hurt. Elbow by Syndel. Adin Reyez in trouble in the corner.
Yeah! That's what wrestling is!
That is my tag team!
A lot of disadvantages coming Adin Reyez's way. Either way, it's a huge upset if he can pull it off. Yeah, great way to come into the league. But you gotta wonder about Matthew Blaze at ringside. That is the numbers game. Syndel has the advantage.
I'm watching my boy!
Nice! Hard shoulder block in the middle of the ring. Adin Reyez taking the time to tumble the opponent. Nice leapfrog. Awesome drag. Syndel's in trouble with the underarm drag. I don't believe this. Look at all these arm tags. And then, scoop and a slam. Shoulders are down. 1, 2, no. Only a 2 count. Not enough, but what momentum for Adin Reyez. His debut here, and Cris Syndel takes it to the outside. So far, Adin Reyez showing himself to be a fighter. Not going to take anything from anyone. Adin Reyez takes it to the outside. Wouldn't be a wise move with Matthew Blaze out there. Back in the ring, this is with that one. Nice jump by Adin Reyez. Gray's got Syndel cinched up. What's he got in mind? Oh, a beautiful vertical suplex in the middle of the ring by Adin Reyez. Up and over, shoulders down. Only a 2 count. Not enough. Cris Syndel, one half of the tag team champions. It's going to take more than that to put him away.
I can do whatever I want.
That's a rookie mistake by Adin Reyez. And there's another mistake. He's engaging Matthew Blaze on the outside. He gets something spit in his eyes. Nice takedown there by Cris Syndel.
He went face first into the second turnbuckle. You know, an I on his forehead.
And now the boots start to fly and Syndel put the shoes in it.
To a flurry of booze.
Tucson, let him know what you think.
Probably not a good idea to take a break against this young upstart. The big chops from Syndel.
Ah.
The rookie in trouble now. Under underhook. Beautiful up and over. The butterfly suplex. Going for the pin. And only a two count.
Ray gets the shoulder up, nice butterfly suplex by the veteran, Syndel. And he's establishing his dominance here, the rookie in trouble.
Hey, get him out of the rope! 1, 2, 3,
Cris Syndel surprisingly obeying the 5 count, but Matthew Blaze not obeying the token bolt.
Oh, Syndel distracting the ref. And Adin Reyez, there's the numbers game we talked about. Matthew Blaze helping his partner out.
I am not. I'm over here. I'm right here. What are you talking about?
Adin Reyez got a tough enough job tonight in his debut for HIW. Ouch. Without any help from Matthew Blaze. Big elbow to the top of the head, and now, nice takeover by Syndel.
And now he walked in with the surfboard.
He is stretching out Adin Reyez. The referee checking if he wants to submit. Will he tap out?
You're done. You are done, Captain Kirk. You're over.
Wait a minute. Adin Reyez, nice reversal.
He's gonna wrestle him now, and then just right back in the net.
Not enough. Syndel throwing him around like a rag doll.
Stay on him, buddy.
I don't think Adin Reyez knows where he is. Tucson, Mr. Gray. Shoulders are down.
That was a very cocky pin, and it definitely was not going to be the end of that.
An arrogant pin cover by the tag team champion, Cris Syndel.
That's what we've come to expect.
Come on. Yeah, that was a 4-year-old.
A lucky fan trying to start a "You Look Stupid" chant.
Syndel. Ouch.
Hits him with the snake eyes. A running single leg drop kick to the face.
Nicely done. Shoulders are down. Syndel stop this. That's all.
Oh, he didn't properly hook the leg.
Not enough. Adin Reyez finding the strength to get that shoulder up. But I don't think he's got much more strength. He's in trouble.
He ain't no one.
Stay down!
He's a no one.
You gotta figure for a first night, they definitely stacked the cards against him.
Yeah, what a great way to come into the league, going up against Cris Syndel.
Cris Syndel, you got this.
With Tucson City Champion Matthew Blaze in his corner.
Cris Syndel.
If wrestling for HOW was easy, everyone would do it. There's a knee to the midsection by Syndel.
Catch him!
Close line!
Drop kick!
Yeah, great elevation. Shoulder down.
He did not hook the leg.
Yeah, Syndel gets that shoulder up. Not enough. That's another rookie mistake.
But wait a minute! That's a gray on the outside! Is he gonna fly? He's climbing the top turnbuckle! Out of the air,
Cris Syndel,
like an anti-aircraft weapon.
Both men are down. The referee carrying him out. Somebody's got to get back up. Great job by Syndel. That move well scouted, and that drop kick took all the length out of Adin Reyez.
Both men have only until the count of 10 to get up. It looks like Gray not gonna give.
Come on, come get me.
Oh no, Adin Reyez.
Shoulders down. 1, 2, 3.
And that is it. Your winner, Cris Syndel. Adin Reyez got distracted on the outside by Matthew Blaze. And Syndel finishes him off.
It was an impressive showing, but Cris Syndel is to prevail.
Get down!
Get down! Give it up for your winner, Tucson, Cris Syndel!
What?
What are they saying? I think they're saying you are awesome. They love Cris Syndel.
Thank you.
his heart out, but the deck was stacked against him. Oh, wait a minute. Now there's good sportsmanship. Adin Gray wants to shake the hands of his opponent. Give it up for Adin Gray. Good sportsmanship is still alive. I love it. Put it there, buddy. Bring it in, buddy.
You want to shake?
What? Not again! What is wrong with Cris Syndel?
Welcome to the big leagues.
We run this house!
Matthew Williams says, welcome to the big leagues. All he was trying to do was shake hands and be a good sport. That is not right. That is, I don't want to use any strong language, guys, but that's BS. That is BS.
While their morals are definitely questionable, it's hard to argue with all their success.
HIW, you keep giving me these new kids that never seen the light of day, and I'll keep racking them up. As between now and then, I am your tag team champions. He is your Tucson City title holder, and all of you suck.
Wow, some strong words from the self-proclaimed tag team champions. So now apparently is one tag team champion. Well, the fans giving up for Adin Gray, who really showed what he had.
Make some noise for Adin Gray, you guys. His first day on the job in HIW. He did great. Nicely done, young man. You got a break. All right, Tucson, what'd you think of that match? Do you like it so far? Yeah! Well, we got a great night ahead, plenty more matches. Are you guys ready for another wrestling match or what? Yeah! You don't sound ready, make some damn noise!
Yeah! Oh my goodness. That's
pretty good.
They're starting to get the hang of it, these fans.
They're learning. They all came here to buy hats or whatever they sell on now they're here for wrestling.
Cool.
First competitor.
I don't think I have to stress with fans, it's not who they think. Ladies and gentlemen, making his return to HIW.
Orthopedic wrestling boots, but somehow they came up with it for him. Let's bring out his opponent.
Uh-oh. That music is not a good sign for an opponent of our next competitor. Checking Twisted for any foreign objects. Now my question is, does the steel plate in Joe Pinsky's head count as a foreign object?
Considering you can't remove it, I think they let it slide.
All right then. And here we go! Hardcore Joe Pinsky, the HIW legend, against Twisted.
And into the power double tie-up, the traditional start of any wrestling match, and launched! Into the corner already!
I know it's so strong.
I think it was pretty obvious, Joe.
Joe Binsky has an unorthodox style, but don't let it fool you. He's held multiple HIW championship belts. Oh! Twisted, overpowering hardcore Joe Binsky. I got a bad feeling about this, Skylar.
I hope Joe Binsky knows moves from half of the poses that he's doing.
Oh,
because he's going to need every single one. And a cartwheel. Probably not smart to talk Twisted.
Ouch. You don't want to make this guy mad. No, it's Bender takeover.
It's a very difficult thing to do, not get Twisted mad. Oh, running dropkick to the face.
Binsky in trouble early. What else is new?
Oh, and a roundhouse kick! You'd be surprised by some of the moves that this man knows. I'm now stepping on the neck.
That's a move that I definitely know hardcore Joe Binsky does not like. Twisted, pulling Binsky to his boots. Oh, whip out. Whip and a slam, nicely done with authority by Twisted. Uh-oh. And now. The big man is gonna go airborne! Oh my god! That is an elbow from hell right to the heart of hardcore Joe Binsky.
Shoulder to the pin! What? Joe kicks out!
Really?
Hardcore Joe Binsky has the heart of a champion and the brain of a 3-year-old.
Yeah, this has got some words for the
referee
in this match. And
it's
the DDT on Twisted!
Nicely done. The cheetah punch is distracted. Twisted. And here comes the shoe leather.
Or shoe leather. And a big one.
My only question, who helps Joe Binsky tie his wrestling shoes? I would have expected Velcro.
Possibly one of his brothers. Which probably should have been at ringside with him for this matchup.
Binsky heading to the outside.
Is he climbing to the top rope?
Wait a minute. I didn't know he could find his way to the top rope. Oh my god!
Oh no.
Cross body did not work. Look out.
Oh my god.
Transitions to a huge suplex. Twisted in control, Binsky in big trouble. He must have made somebody mad backstage to get this match.
I think they asked for volunteers and he was dumb enough to raise his hand. Oh, wait a minute, what's going on here?
Big chop to the chest of Joe Binsky as Hissa distracts the ref.
Yeah,
the
referee's got to get her out of there.
Wait, it's not Azteca!
What the hell?
Kill the man!
Oh my god! Azteca is a DDT from hell!
Two-thirds of the members of Flash Tekka.
Uh-oh, look out, the elbow pad comes off!
The Binsky elbow! What a cartwheel!
A numbers game as Tekka came out of nowhere.
Justice Supreme also ringside. New third of Flash Tekka.
It helps to have friends. And now that elbow pad being used as a bludgeon. Oh my god!
I don't think rules were ever established in this matchup.
People, if you could throw that elbow pad, you'd understand.
Uh-oh.
Oh no. Oh no.
Looking at the shirt.
Shut up!
A chop from hell. Those open-handed chops laid in there by Twisted. And wait a minute. What the hell?
Using her belt to choke her instantly as the ref is distracted.
His mouth. But Twisted back in control, Binsky asphyxiated. He doesn't have much blood in his brain to begin with. Oh no.
What?
Oh my god! High impact move by Twisted, and now the stats are down. This match is over.
Oh, you all know what's coming next. Ladies and gentlemen, the Twisted Sisters. This match concludes.
Oh, winner, Twisted.
Wait, Azteca checking on Binsky.
Yes.
What connections can Flash Tekka have with her coach on Binsky?
Azteca got involved earlier, and I don't think Twisted was very happy about it. Look out behind you, Azteca. You're in trouble.
What do we have here?
Twister is not somebody you want on the bad side, and now Justice Supreme and Azteca taunting them from the middle of the ring.
This could spell a lot of trouble.
Oh, wait a minute, they're not gonna wait! Twister back in the ring!
Oh, kick the
ring. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, and a punch to the lower region.
What's wrong with two for one here?
From Justice Supreme.
Justice Supreme is asking for trouble. She's all over Hissa. What is she thinking? I think we're going to see some more of the lead sport competitors, people. And it isn't going to be pretty. Nobody goes up against Twisted like this. Nobody.
the ring with Justice Supreme.
They call him Ice Cream Tucker, you guys.
Here comes the pose. Flash Tucker. Have a last laugh.
From Azteca. What's going on?
Hey, yeah.
So we got Twisted out here at the Big and Bad. Beat up on a guy way smaller than him. But looks like a guy half his size. Twisted, but a little bit. What do you think? Justice Supreme.
Hey,
I don't think it's going to be over between us and Twisted. What do you think?
I don't think so either. I'm going to snatch that girl up again. Twisted doesn't have to like it if he's like it.
Now, for those of you who don't know who we are, we're Justice Supreme and Azteca. Now, you're probably going to see more of us for the fact that we have unfinished business now with Twisted and his... What is
his thing?
His thing.
His thing.
So if you want to see more of us whipping on Twisted and his side chick thing, give me a oh yeah.
All right, it looks like the people have spoken. They want more of that Azteca Justice Supreme matchup in the ring. What do you think? You guys want to see some more of those too? Hell yeah!
As a journalist, I can only wonder what their intentions were.
Well, I don't know if they were thinking clearly, because nobody in their right mind is going to go in there, lock horns with Twisted and Hissa. It's just not good business, people. Not good business at all.
Not if you want a long career.
All right, Tucson, we've got another match for you. This is a very special matchup. It is for the Tucson City Championship. Let's bring out our first competitor. Champion to make those dreams come true.
Champion,
study.
All right, the champion comes down to the ring. He's accompanied by all of his companions, I guess would be the nicest way to put it. And he doesn't want to give that belt up. Ladies and gentlemen, the referee's got the title. That's what these men are competing for. The Tucson City Championship. Roya V. Blaze. Daniel Loya, in my opinion, this is a non-biased opinion, mind you, stands no chance. No chance whatsoever.
All right, Cris Syndel had a great night earlier, winning an opening matchup against Evan Gray. Now he's going to be doing some announcing.
All right. You ready? Are you, buddy, ready? All right, looks good. Come on, Syndel.
There's Cris!
Right here, buddy!
There's Cris!
I mean, Blaze, we're not buddies. It is a love fest down here with Ogre, Syndel, and Blaze. But we got a title match to take care of here. And I don't think Loya gives one damn who's down here to play.
Well, he should, because he's going up against Matt. And there's no reason why Matthew Blaze shouldn't walk all over him today.
Come on. So now, do you have to have those feet up on the table?
I mean, I'm
comfortable.
I can have a match.
Yeah, all right. In the ring, Hammerlock. Hammerlock applied by the champ. Moved to a front headlock by Matthew Blaze. Roy in trouble early in this championship tilt.
Trouble early and trouble from now on.
Matthew Blaze with a big smile on his face. He couldn't be happier with himself.
He's completely dominating at this point. Completely dominating and going to dominate this whole match.
Ouch. Blaze firing in those knees. Roya, not the start he wanted for his shot at HIW Glory.
Blaze and fire. I see what you did there, Jeff, man. Good one. This is why I like you. But you see, he also has the blazing knees. When he puts them in, he just lights something on fire.
Well, hold on, now Loya fighting back, using his head, and some trouble down to the mat. Oh, the champion! Recover attempt, way too early by Loya.
All of those were illegal. The ref has no idea what he's doing.
All of the HIW referees have to pass a stringent test. It was a math test, however.
To count to three?
Pretty much.
Oh, well, I've seen some who couldn't, so tell me about those.
Loya working the left arm of the champion. Blaze in trouble, gets to a critical base. Look out, he's got him hooked. Front headlock, it looks like, by the champ, and Loya in trouble. The champion with the knees to the midsection.
Those knees are the most dangerous thing Matthew Blaze has.
And down goes Loya. And now an armbar put in by the champ. Turnabout is fair play as he's working the shoulder of the challenger.
Wrench on that board, you can dislocate it. Just a little word of advice.
Oh my god.
And the fingers.
He is going to break that arm. Ref, keep an eye on this. Oh!
You don't know where those things have been, dude.
And he is working the fingers one by one for Daniel Loya. That left hand is in bad, bad shape. The challenger in big, big trouble.
He's working that hammer now. He's going to put in that devastating finger lock. And Daniel Loya has no chance to tap out.
A finger lock would be pretty tough at this point. Loya in trouble. Still on the arm, targeting that left arm of the challenger. I don't know what you call this. Maybe is it the pretzel?
We call it the blaze knot.
The blaze knot.
Yeah. I just made that up right now, but I'm sure that's what he calls it.
Good work by Loya to get the shoulders up. He can be pinned in this situation. Hold on, he's rolling the champ over. Nicely done. Blaze's shoulders on the mat. He nearly got pinned.
You gotta be careful.
careful of that, because when you get your shoulders down, you get hit.
The champion in the driver's seat, Loya, struggling early, and he continues to target the arms of Daniel Loya. Ouch! Another painful submission locked in by the champion.
He has to target the arms because we call Daniel Loya Daniel the Octopus Loya, because he just has arms for days.
Hold on a minute, wait a minute! Nice reversal!
Pulse,
not enough. Matthew Blaze is a challenger. Back down to the mat. Ladies and gentlemen, the Tucson City title on the line here tonight at the Tanque Verde Swap Meet. And that knee of the champion digging into the shoulder of Daniel Loya.
Shades of flair right there. Just elbow dropping everything he could get his hands on.
The champion, confident and in control. And Loya is being systematically picked apart by Matthew Blaze.
What do you say, Loya? No! Get over it!
Again with the submission hold. The ref asking Loya, will you submit? He says no.
What his best bet right now would to be submit, because he's just not working out right now. There's no way.
Uh-oh, look out, now Loya locked up.
Oh, yeah.
See how that's the Blaze clutch. See how he's got the fingers in the nostril?
Dude!
That lights him on fire.
A modified camel clutch, the Blaze clutch. And he is pulling on everything Daniel Loya's got on his head. The ref watching him very closely, and he's got to break that hold. But how much damage done to the challenger?
Quite a bit, if I don't have to say so myself.
It's the expert commentary we're used to from you, Mr. Sandler.
Oh, you know.
Continuing to lift that shoulder. I hope Daniel Loya doesn't have to do any push-ups later. Those arms have been targeted. Wait a minute! Wait a minute! Loya! You have moved!
Come on, rope! Come on!
He's too close to the ropes. Matthew Blaze knows where the ropes are in this ring, and he gets to
them. The champion gets his boots on the rope. He's got to break that old Loya with a lift. And he's taken off by Daniel Loya.
Took him straight off his feet. Not too many people can do that.
Loya trying to build some momentum, trying to work some life into those damaged arms. I don't know if you can wrestle with two busted arms, but we'll find out.
I wrestle with two busted arms and two busted legs.
Nine fingers.
Use your torso.
Come on, please.
Loya, nice drop kick. That's all he's got left to work with, those legs. A beautiful kick by the challenger.
I don't know if he got all of that. There it goes.
Oh, look out now. Look out. Blaze trying to lock in that triangle. That's a submission hold. He can chuck him out of that. And those right hands.
Blaze first tries to knock his opponents out.
He may not get a chance to submit. Wait a minute, wait a minute. Loya's okay. Loya is not going to submit. He's going to hold him down.
He's going to watch those shoulders.
Not enough.
Matthew, I would have it released.
Matthew Blaze continues to work the arm. Loya trying to build some momentum. Some short arm elbows in there.
Great kick out. I don't know what these people are cheering, but they should already know that Matthew Blaze is too smart for this.
I think they're cheering for the challenger, man. Daniel Loya.
Well, then they're all idiots.
Loya with some shoe leather for the champion.
If I was a betting man, which I'm not because I used to live in Utah, I'm not Mormon or anything. I have all my money on Matthew Blaze right now.
And now a submission hold by the challenger, Loya, working the leg of the champ, Matthew Blaze. Looks like he was in big trouble. Oh, my God. He is stretching Blaze out. Blaze may tap. A dangerous situation.
never tap out. I've been blamed for being unconscious. We were one moment away from a new champion here in Tucson.
I wouldn't say that close. He had it in the bag. He knew what he was doing.
Ouch, and Blaze with that drop kick right to the cranium of the challenger. But Blaze looks like he is in trouble. He's favoring that leg. Roya may have done some damage to the champion. Blaze may have a problem on his hand, on his leg.
He just needs to walk it off right now. Just take a few laps, walk it off, get back in, and beat that crap out of the way.
Both men on their knees, firing right hands.
You see, that's the difference between Blaze and Loya right now, is Blaze hits like a boxing champion, Loya hits like my grandma.
My grandma's pretty tough.
My grandma's dead, Jeff, man.
I'm sorry. Blaze, the champion, getting the challenger to his boots.
Oh, nice job there.
That's a head on that one. A beautiful counter by the challenger. Look out! Move up there! That broken arm over the chest of the champion, but it's like a piece of spaghetti. He couldn't keep him down.
A piece of broken spaghetti. Broken spaghetti.
Like dry?
Wet.
Al dente. I speak fluent Italian. The challenger to his boots. He'll fight the referee. He's gone. Wait a minute.
Loya in trouble, right in the middle of the ring. He's got no other choice to tap out.
Blaze is gonna break.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Bring your bell.
Bring that bell.
Appeals to the law against his fellow man as either a fool or a coward. Whoever cannot take care of himself without that law is both. For a wounded man shall say to his assailant, if I live, I will kill you. If I die, you are forgiven. Such is the rule of honor.
My nigga just a nigga business, so gonna get a witness. Give you the fuck.
How to get something.
My partner Cris Syndel and I beat Tyrone Cabrone and Matt Cabot for the HIW Tag Team Championships. Yeah, I think he wants a little bit more of the winged people. Now he just chose a bad night to be in here against my man, the Ogre. Both of these men, they are in the semifinals for the vacant HIW Heavyweight Championship. And oh no, so let's get things started. I guess we're done.
All right, here we go. Tyrone Cabrone couldn't wait to get the action started. He wants every advantage he can get against this powerhouse Ogre.
Hey, the only thing I can say is that's the way you get an advantage on Ogre, but I think he just pissed him off.
Uh-oh. I think he just made him mad.
Ogre's not one to be taken lightly. You took it from behind. He's not going to let you forget it. Tyrone's got to strike quick and try to chop the big man down, but I know Ogre. Ogre's just going to tie right through him.
Ogre, hailing from the Pacific Northwest, frequently mistaken for a sequoia tree.
A sequoia tree. Jeff, man. He's a monster. He'll rip any opponent's head right off. And in a few short months, he is going to be your reigning HIW Heavyweight Champion. And then the Evil League of Evil will have every single championship in HIW.
Tyrone Cabrone on the outside. He's in danger of being
caught. He stopped off to hang out with the fans. He's a friendly guy.
Hey, he's taking a breather, and I don't blame him. You get hit by that beast, you're going to want to gather yourself and try again.
Tyrone Cabrone, an established HIW veteran, held many, many titles here in High Impact Wrestling, rolls in,
rolls back out to start that count again. A veteran move. And Tyrone Cabrone asking the ref to give him a clean entrance back into the ring. I think it's fair.
Ogre's not going to stand for that.
Ogre.
Now he's just waiting for his prey.
Ogre respecting the ref for a change.
Hey, he's a lot nicer than I am, I'll tell you that.
Cabrone back in the ring. This match back underway.
They're circling. It's like a shark circling his prey in the ocean right now. And now he's going to go for
a test of strength. What is he thinking?
I think we knocked him out too hard a couple weeks ago.
Ogre's got three. He can't even reach his hand. Ogre's got 300 pounds on him.
Up, he's going low.
All right. They've got it locked in.
This is a bad move on Tyrone. Oh.
Disrespect.
And disrespect. Big man hands, and now the big shoulder of the big man.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you want some souvenirs, Tyrone's teeth scattered right here by the chinbuckle. Get them while they're fresh.
Ogre throwing Tyrone Cabrone around like a rag doll. And now, chopping him on the ropes. What the hell?
Look, I'm telling you right now, Jeff, man. Ogre, Cris Syndel, myself, we've been passed up too many times. We're showing HIW why we're the dominant team and why we're going to have all the belts. Right now, we're in control. Just wait a couple months. We'll be in complete control of HIW. Don't call it.
What do they get this? These refs at the bargain bin somewhere? Come on.
Cabrone going after the eyes of the big man, and right now he's deciding to survive.
Two, three, four.
You ever fought a blind giant before, Jeff? Ogre can't fight if he can't see. It might be good strategy by his outgunned, outmatched opponent.
He's swinging for the fences right now. Referee, give him a count of five. Tyrone using any advantage. See, I have a lot of respect for the Church of Havoc. I don't really particularly like Tyrone Cabrone, but take as many advantages as you can against the big man. That's the best way you're going to try to beat him. Now there's elbows to the top of the head. Now the forearm right to the jaw. He's manhandling Ogre. Ooh, that's a chop right to the chest.
And that doesn't happen very often. Ogre is on the short end of this. And Tyrone Cabrone is in control.
Come on, Ogre. Now he's going to be a blind, angry giant. Tyrone Cabrone, grabbing him by the hair. Referee, will you pay attention? No. Now he thinks he's going to brain buster the big man?
I don't think that's going to work.
That's a pretty stupid move, if I do say so myself, Jeff Man.
Tyrone Cabrone trying to suplex the big man. He's giving away 300 pounds.
Oh, face first on the mat.
Oh, my goodness.
Grasping that chest. Ogre's taking a moment to catch himself. Now he's just staring down Tyrone Cabrone. Oh, that's a lot of weight on that dome.
Tyrone's
just squeezed the pain right out of Tyrone. He's putting his full weight on that melon. You ever seen Ogre squash a watermelon?
Not yet.
It's pretty disgusting. And that's what just happened. Good leg drop right to the throat. I don't know how Tyrone kicked out of that.
That was an arrogant cover by Ogre. Cabrone kicks out. Good on him.
Look at this crowd out here in the swap meet just watching my man destroy Tyrone right now. Make some noise if you want to see Ogre destroy Tyrone right now.
Oh my god!
Decapitating clothesline right there, Jeff Van.
That was one hell of a lariat thrown out there by the big man Ogre. Cabrone in trouble once again in this match. He's been on a disadvantage the whole way off the rope. Another poser.
You know how Ogre advanced to the semifinals of the HIW heavyweight title tournament? He beat Yeti. Yeti is the only other man in HIW as big as Ogre. With the exception of Monster Mayhem, of course.
Ogre's got the advantage for sure in this matchup, but Tyrone Cabrone will not go quietly into that good night. He is fighting hard.
Now he's putting him up on that top rope. What are we going to see the big man do right now?
Nice job, short arm clothesline from the top rope, and Ogre looking for some love. What do you think, Tucson? I think these people are just afraid to boo Ogre. I know I am.
You shouldn't boo the better man in the ring right now, Jeff Van. You should be cheering him and giving him the dang respect he deserves.
Ogre, one of the most well-respected competitors in HIW history. No doubt about it, Matthew West.
That's why I'm glad he's on my side, not against me.
Cabrone and
Cabrone. What a jawbreaker right on the big man, stunning him. He may have bit his tongue clean off.
Cabrone fighting back any way he can. Trying to hit the off button on this big man.
It's a smart move because if Ogre didn't affect just by the tongue, it's swelled up in his mouth. It's making him hyper breathe. For the big man.
Oh! Ogre is down!
No, come on.
What is going on?
Big man.
Come on, big man. Come on, big man.
Come on, big man.
Ogre hits the shoulder up. Again, the leg is hooked! Two and 15 sixteenths.
Oh man. We're 2-0 so far. Come on, big man.
This
get
crowd.
Up and make it 3-0. Come on, big man. Don't listen to them.
Getting behind.
I don't care about this stupid crowd. Stupid crowd's been in my face all night. I don't care what they want.
I think these people want to see Tyrone Cabrone win this match.
I want all these people to shut up. It's not going to happen. Oh, he just palmed the head and dropped him right there. I don't think he got all of that button masher. Nope, he's going for it again. Oh, no.
Oh, my God!
It's over.
Faking him up like an accordion.
One, two. Good night, Tyrone.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Ogre!
Give me water. Let's go! Match wins. The first team to get two pinfalls will win. This match means the locks of Dr. Cobblepot. He is avenging his friend, Chad Hockley, in this match. Nice.
I think Cobblepot's doing whatever he can to fight off that onslaught. Castro was laying on him, and both men outside the ring.
He broke his
legs! Oh, wait a minute. Outrage at Entapryze.
Two biggest men in the match are meeting face to face.
I don't know.
Two veterans of our sport, both decorated in their own respects.
Absolutely. Outrage has done things in this ring that I've never seen anybody do. He is fearless.
Entapryze showing off his power.
Yeah, Entapryze isn't scared either. Entapryze says, I'm not ready.
Using some a little salty language against the crowd in any language.
Alright,
Roger! Get him! Break his mind!
Get
him!
I
have you! Do that!
Oh, and that one's gonna hit the leg and jump. Yeah, nice. Finger right. Take down, up and over. Thanks for the shoulder, but not enough!
Hey, guys, with a running arm tag, finally gets Entapryze down. And a running forward drop kick. Entapryze is going to take a break.
Outrageous, I am.
Wait. And now, Alamoradora and Adin Reyez. Now his least favorite chant, the fans know it.
That
is not effective wrestling by El Amor Adora.
What do you mean? He's playing that game. Oh, but this time he grabs the leg, buddy. Uh-oh. It looks like he might have tweaked the knee. He can get the kick to the shoulder if there's troubles.
Yeah, he's trying to take away the vertical base of his stronger opponent. And a takeover by Reyes. And a knee right to the back of the spine. Reyes back on top. And he's running start. This is the crowd just made, and here comes Entapryze.
The first ball goes to the team of Dr.Cobblepot.
Don't give up his real name, man.
Now maybe some of you didn't hear, because Mr. Jesus doesn't speak up too loud. But this match is a Lucha Libre Falls match. Door 3-4. Shut up! Shut up! I have a microphone!
I tell you what, you want to tell me to shut up? You want to tell me to shut up?
Oh, there you go.
Got the crowd behind him.
We stand right now.
Ladies and gentlemen.
have some dancing.
Dance for your husband.
Second fall, gonna go to a dance-off.
Doing the dance-off too much.
I think they're dancing. The match is not over, folks. They're just taking a dance break.
Who's got that dance break? What the hell is going on?
Getting the second fight. With a huge attack by Alvarez and Castro.
And they had enough of that dancing. Remember, the team is in a battle. Yeah.
Hit him with the chair.
I knew this was bullshit.
Cabrone.
Hey, if it's just some people, it's getting on us. And they can't tell if